Yeah, what's happening, everyone? It's me, SSSasuke125 here. Today we're going to be playing Gunvolt Chronicles Luminous Avenger 9, or IX. Anyway, it's time we get started. I'm going to set up my controller, and here we go. We're going to start a new game. So yeah, this game stars Copen, which is awesome. It takes place in like an alternate sort of like a what if after, like, you know, Azure Striker Gunvolt 1, like in like the one of the alternate universes bad endings. And this is of course not canon, so the main series, so. But anyway, here we are playing as, like, Topin. He plays exactly how he did, like, as a Striker 2, as you can see. Only difference is, like, he has, like, a different sprite, sort of, and his gameplay feels a little bit much more refined. So if you played him in Azure Striker 2, you know, his story, then you'll pretty much, since you enjoyed his gameplay in that game, you'll enjoy it here. It's funny how this game got released first on Steam, but yet the sequel to the original game, you know, had to wait for like a few years to get a Steam re-release. Which is kind of odd. You would think, like, after Azure Striker Gunvolt 1, they would release, like, the second game on Steam immediately, but no. But yeah, it's funny how I first learned how to play as Koku from this game, which is interesting. And much like in those games, there are, you know, the whole level up RPG mechanic, which is nice. So here we are, like, facing the first mini boss. Pretty easy stuff. Pretty self-explanatory. And that takes care of that. And also, what's cool about this game is that the freaking, you know, combat system with Copen is not only a lot more refined, but you also have more options of various upgrades for the character, which is pretty awesome. Here we are at the true first intro to the boss. And this character is supposed to be like the rival. And we took care of her pretty easily. Yes, it's a chick underneath. Obviously. You get for a rank, you get a B rank. Not so exciting, honestly. But whatever. Anyway, we already took care of that, so we're going into the ruins. So here we go. Mission Also, unlike, you know, Azure Strike with Gunvolt 1 and 2, there's no, like, true ending you have to worry about getting. It's pretty straightforward. Yeah, there's, like, a boss rush thing at the end. Like, a boss rush level. After you beat the, like, main game. But those are, like, extra stuff that you can do. But other than that, you know, I'm just gonna go, like, through a simple, you know, play from beginning to end. Just all which is nice. Yeah, just going through like this ruined city type area. Also, another thing about this game, since it's like a spin-off, that it takes place 100 years in like the future. Meaning that, you know, humanity's kind of gone to shit and the adepts have kind of taken over. Blazing through the stage, make some combos. Here we are at the boss. Press that button, but...
しよう。
And the boss is about to do their overtrial attack by Limit Break, so... Usually not that time. Luckily, if I caught him, I probably would not have really done a whole lot of damage, so that's good. And just like that, I took care of Red Man over there. And yes, that's what I'm going to nickname the boss is, obviously. Because why the hell not? Now let's see what I got. And I got a B-ring! Nice! Oh yeah. So yeah, I'm totally excited about, like, freaking, you know, Vault 3 when it comes out. Oh yeah, and this is something that's another improvement with this game is that, compared to the other two games, is that when it comes to buying items in the store and shit, you don't need, like, a other material to get it. You just use, like, your currency, which is nice. And, oh, look! And it's pretty much more simple to buy stuff. For this one, I'm gonna go into Fearless, because, well, that's the most recommended, you know, kiddo style, which makes sense. Anyway, let's get started. God damn it. Oh yeah, and with some attacks, like Chrissy and stuff, like, you don't get, like, an invisibility thing if you have your bullets loaded or something. So, be careful. And also, luckily, like in other previous entries, that was normal mode, you know, you don't get an easy kill if you touch spikes, but you still damage you, which makes sense. Again, this is one thing I love about this series over Mega Man. Mega Man series in general is that spikes don't kill you in one hit. And plus, this game, when it comes to difficulty, is a lot more forgiving, but still provides a bit of challenge in certain aspects. Again, that's not to say Mega Man X isn't like that, but I feel like this is honestly a pretty good successor to the Mega Man series, unlike the Mighty Number 9. Hell, again, you could say this game particularly is basically what if Mighty Number 9 was actually good and felt more like a Mega Man X game. Hell, I mean, Copen would actually fit pretty well within the Mega Man X game. Not just because of the sprite, but because of the terms of this gameplay. I mean, could you imagine, like, being able to not only, you know, wall climb, but do so in a very fast manner? You can have, like, a pretty awesome homing type of attack. It's not like it's a combination of, say, like, Mega Man X, Zero, and Sonic the Hedgehog. Sonic the Hedgehog in the fact that, you know, he can homing attack, which is awesome. Anyway. Here's the next boss. And the boss is like the gravity and shit, so. Oh yeah, and this attack kind of reminds me a bit of Gravity Antonio's block ability from like Mega Man X. Oh shit, I died. Whoop! And luckily, just like in freaking the other Azure Striker Gunvolt games, is that sometimes if you die, you can actually keep it like a second revival chance. Pretty convenient. And booyah! And took care of that. And now I got like one of the best sub weapons in the game. After defeating her. And I got a C rank. Yeah, I mean, figure since I docked. Anyway, we're gonna do like an extra one more other save and engage. You know, when I first played this game, it was actually kind of difficult to really master, but after a while, you get used to it. I mean, the number thing with Goku, he finds that he's a lot more head-on type of a player, which is kind of cool, but also can be risky. It's sort of a risky move, was just, oh, and be careful about those red containers, and so is those are like really cool. So yeah, this stuff left is really nice and how it can do like a lot of damage. But it's pretty useful when it comes to dealing with bosses. Not every boss has the same weakness, of course, like in every traditional Mega Man type game, but that's another thing I like about this series is that It's not as similar to the Mega Man X series, but it doesn't feel like a clone to it. It has its own identity and its own feel to it, which is pretty cool. You know, and speaking about Azure Strike and Gunvolt Weekend, is that... that the new character, Karine... I'm guessing she'll probably be similar to, like, Zero from Mega Man X in terms of gameplay style. Short range, mainly, and, you know, to do, like, a pretty good amount of damage and have a very cool combo. Yeah, well, I mean, even if it hit me, you know, I would still have plenty of health to do with it. Oh yeah, and those, like, wires. The spring, those, like, traps, so... And it also has really awesome, like, pretty good range. It covers, like, a good amount of the screen. So... there we go. And we're at the boss. Also, this boss reminds me a lot of Destiny from Mega Man Zero. Both males have, like, a explosion type thing and a similar color pattern. Anyway, watch as I just shred this boss to pieces. And it's funny, this boss gave me quite a lot of trouble during my first playthrough of this game, but it's kind of a joke. Since you have this beat, you can have it now. You know how to map the gameplay system. And just like that, I shredded his ass pretty easily. Booyah! Wow. See, what did I tell you about it? It's really good for shredding bosses, well. And I got a B rank, even though I clearly should have gotten at least an A rank for that, but... but whatever, you know. But yeah, anyway, this is SS Sasuke 125 here, and I'll see you all later. Peace.